Hey everybody, today we're going to talk about washing your own wig. Now before I get into washing your own wig, I want to get into a little bit about why. Now I tried to make this video a couple times already and it came out a little too long and I had to cut it up. So today we're going to talk about why I give out this information, what's beneficial to knowing this information, and then we're going to make a separate video, and that'll be our next post. We'll make a separate video about actually washing. In addition to all that, actual washing is going to be a little hard to get into in a video because, as you can see, my sink situation is not conducive. Well, you can't really see completely, but you know, just to give you an idea, my sink situation is not really conducive to setting up a camera with good lighting and everything. So I will just, in the next video, we're going to just walk you through how to do it verbally. And I have some written instructions, and it's been on my blog for years, and I can DM you the link, so you can just DM me to ask me. On Instagram, we won't be able to provide the link, but on YouTube and on Facebook, we will be able to provide the link to the blog washing instructions in our next video. So, why I give out this information, I think is partially more interesting than the actual washing information. So I wanted to discuss that. I've been giving out this information for years, and people have always asked me, aren't you taking away business from yourself, from other people? Why would you give out information if this is protected professional information? Here's my answer. Number one, I don't feel like I'm giving out protected information. I feel that there are plenty of people out there who are going to wash their own wigs anyway. And I feel that if I give you the tools to wash it properly rather than not washing it properly, you're better off. Number one, 9 out of 10 of the people who try to wash their wig once find it to be too much work and actually end up going back to paying a professional and do it every once in a while in case of an emergency. Number two, if I give you the tools to prevent damage, that usually creates more loyal customers, and that works for me. It doesn't work for other professionals, but again, like I said, 9 out of 10 people are not actually going to do it. And number three, the people who actually go and wash their wigs would do it anyway if I didn't give out instructions on how to prevent damage and how to do things properly. And those people would then show up with damage that has to be repaired. So you're saving $25 here, $50 there, whatever the price of a wash and set is in your area, $75, $125, whatever it is. You're saving that money, but you're going to end up with $300 to $700 worth of repair work if you lose too much hair, if you irreversibly damage the wig and loosen up the stitches. So you'll find when I do post my washing instructions that it's all about two major concepts, and you'll have to wait for the next video in order to get it completely. But it's all about two major concepts. Concept number one is going to be, and these concepts are intertwined. Concept number one is going to be about residue. The more residue you leave in a wig, the less time your wash and set will last. So if you leave behind shampoo, residue left on the hair will collect dirt and make your wig dirtier sooner. So that's number one. And we're talking about shampoo and conditioner are both considered residue. Number two is about preserving the integrity of the knots. And I mentioned this already, preserving the integrity of the knots that are holding onto the hair in your wig and getting longer life out of your wig. So these concepts are intertwined because the residue, if it's left in the stitches, in the knots that are holding onto the hairs, the residue will also loosen the stitches. So residue, 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 tightening stitches, preserving the integrity of the stitches. These are going to be the running themes in my instructions. Stay tuned. We're going to try to bring that to you as soon as possible and provide links between the two videos so that you can go back and forth and understand the concepts and also understand the washing instructions together.